Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the kickoff. The Super Bowl is over, but we're having another kickoff for Ellie G's Dream World. I want to welcome everybody. I'm Ken Moore. I'm the mayor of Franklin, and it's such an honor to be here and be part of this today. I know we have some of our elected officials here. I've seen Alderman Peterson, and I've seen Alderman Brown, and I saw our vice mayor, who you'll hear from shortly. And who have I missed as far as aldermen? So, glad to have you. I see City Administrator Eric Stuckey here, and I see Vernon Girth back there. So welcome to everybody, and any other elected officials from the county or the state, welcome also. You know, we're a rapidly growing city, and whenever you're growing rapidly like we are, many of the services that we provide also grow at the same time. And also, we identify more and more needs in our community. And one of the needs we've identified for a very long time is the opportunity to have a playground where everyone can play, what we call an inclusive playground. So we're here today to raise money. Now, here's the deal. This is a good deal. If you will raise $1.5 million, Eric Stuckey is going to authorize $1.5 million check. Right, Eric?
Absolutely.
So I urge you all to be generous today. We're glad to accept a promise. We're glad to accept cash. We're glad to accept checks. We're also glad to accept credit cards. This is a partnership with Friends of Franklin Parks, who has done so much great work in our community at Harlansdale, and they continue to spread their footprint throughout the city, and this is such a great opportunity with our new Southeast Park to build Ellie G's Dream World. So Lisa Clayton's going to come up now, and right behind me.
That's it.
Want the hat?
Oh.
Yes, definitely. Speaker's hat.
It is the mayor only that I would do this. All right. Well, welcome, everyone. I'm Lisa Clayton. I'm the Parks Director, and I'm so glad you're in this room today. There's so many people to thank and that type of thing, but I see many of my parks team that is here, many of the city team that's come out in different divisions and departments, so thank you for being here. Change the way we play. Change the way we play. Remember that, because if you take anything home today, I want you to remember, change the way we play. It's an amazing tagline, but it's also a great motto, and it's also the truth. Change the way we play. About 10 years ago, under the direction of Mindy Tate, who is in this room today, with Franklin Tomorrow, under her leadership, she brought leaders and citizens together to discuss what an inclusive playground in Franklin would look like. They didn't have a location yet. They just knew the idea should be part of our community. Change the way we play. Fast forward about 5 years, we were doing a parks master plan. And in that master plan, we knew that we needed to make it part of that plan. So we took that idea, and we didn't know how, we didn't know when, we didn't know where. But we too knew that we must change the way we play. Change the way we play. The idea and the concept made it into the design for the municipal complex, the Southeast Park. And there, That is where a group of citizens, and we're going to bring those names up, is there many are in this room today that gave 2 years, let me say that, 2 years, their passion and help with the design of what this inclusive playground means. So as you come by, and we're going to have this scrolling today, there are so many names, but when you see one of those people up there that you know, say thank you. This is an amazing group of our people, our community, who designed this playground. So thank you so much, because they too understood that we must change the way we play. Change the way we play. The family is here with us. I'm going to try not to get up. Elliot Grace Castro. This family had the foresight. They used to do events right here at Eastern Flank. And when that child couldn't even go outside and play, they created a space for our children to play. And so it was a no-brainer when the inclusive playground idea came forth and the impact that this child had on this community, LEG's Dream World came about. And so not only will her memory be remembered, and we are going to change the way we play, this inclusive playground is going to change how people play for generations. So, we're about to find out how special she was and what this means. We're going to play a video, and after this video, I'm going to ask that the Brandy come up. In any of the Blanton or the Castro family that would like to say a few words. Tori?
She never walked, she never talked, she couldn't support her head, but she was like the happiest girl you've ever met in your entire life.
She was here for 4 years and the community just wrapped the arms around us.
For us, it's an Elliot thing, but also for me, it's about this community and everybody being able to enjoy playing.
Looking at a field of dreams. This is land where the Southeast Municipal Complex will be built. The master plan for this large park features multi-use fields, basketball, pickleball, a sand volleyball court, and an open lawn and picnic pavilion. It will be a place where folks can come out to play, exercise, or just relax. There are also plans for a one-of-a-kind playground named after a one-of-a-kind little girl who stole Franklin's heart the moment she was born and broke it the moment she left us. This is LEG's Dream World.
LEG, or Elliot Grace, is our daughter. She was born May 30th of 2015. When I was pregnant with her, we just knew that she had a heart issue, but we found out when she was 2 days old that she had a terminal form of dwarfism called rhizomelic chondrodysplasia punctata, RCDP. Elle came home from the hospital and we didn't think she would make it much longer than a week, and she lived over 4 years. She would just light up anyone's world who met her. And she had all sorts of therapies throughout her life. She had occupational therapy, physical therapy, feeding therapy, and speech therapy. So our life was consumed with Elliot's therapies, as well as her 13 doctors that she saw.
Franklin's vice mayor, Brandy Blanton, LEG's grandmother, or Gimmy, as she is referred to at home, would give updates on Elliot's progress to a hopeful community.
She meant a lot to a lot of people, even more so than Samantha and I could even know, because we were at home with her a lot because of her condition. We couldn't take her out a whole lot, but we would hear about it. We would see the Facebook post. I mean, hundreds and hundreds of responses.
Brandy would share Elliot's wonderful wins, serious struggles, major milestones, and thank goodness, lots of laughter. Fundraisers helped lighten the load for LEG's family, And it was one of those events where the name of Franklin's first inclusive playground came about.
So I was doing signage for the event, and I got to where we were doing the kids area, and I called Samantha, and I said, Samantha, would you want me to just call this kids area? I mean, that's pretty generic. And she said, oh no, I have the perfect name. I'm like, okay, what is that? And she said, LEG Stream World. I'm like, got it. And to us and to her, that meant it was providing a space for these children to enjoy that Ellie could never in the way that they were going to.
There was giraffes, there were lions, there was just this wonderful atmosphere. And so those were the things in which the family loved. It's the things in which she loved, because she loved the color purple, that you will see this inside that playground for kids to enjoy.
Building an inclusive playground in one of our city parks has been in the plans for years. Finding LEG's Dream World's home was something that happened more recently.
When LEG was born in 2015, we were actually putting an inclusive playground in a parks master plan that same year. We're not sure where or the timing of it all, but we knew that that was needed in our community, and that was basically part of a plan that Franklin Tomorrow was visioning almost 10 years ago prior to that. So as those events took place at Eastern Flank, by the time that we started a community type committee to look at the design for the playground, we were beginning by 2019 to do a master plan for Southeast, where we are today shooting on site. And so the playground was going to be here.
A lot of planning has gone into creating LEG's Dream World on paper, making sure thoughtful measures are in place that will accommodate anyone who uses this special area.
The playground will have a pavilion. It'll have the restrooms are important to discuss, because it would allow for not only those with disabilities that are children, but also adults in our community that might just need extra assistance.
The park's not just for children. There's stuff for folks of every age, and it's a real chance to make an impact on a lot of people. And these kids and these adults, they're just really, really special, and I think that they deserve this, and I'm glad it's coming to Franklin.
You know, while we really wish she was still here to enjoy it, that's not realistic, but to know that her brothers and her cousins and even her gimme can go to that playground and enjoy it.
I hope that, one, for those who didn't know her, they get a glimpse into her life and the things that she enjoyed or appreciated, but also for the families who have kids with special needs, that they get to go to a place where all their children or family members can play together. Going to the park is oftentimes where families spend their weekends, and so to go to a place where people get to kind of hear about her, or at least can read her story, and it's amazing, and it's also great for us to be able to have something to just remember her, because I think when anyone passes away, you fear they're going to be forgotten. And for a four-year-old child, they're not here for a very long time, and so you just think, okay, those 4 years, they're just going to go away, but she's just going to stay. Her memory will stay in Franklin. I think that's really awesome.
I told somebody earlier, this is almost like picking a scab off, but it's such a blessing. I mean, whose life is this that we were blessed with Elliot to begin with? And so many people in this room were a part of our team, Elliot. I look at my friends over here and here, and then our family. This is our newest Castro. This Knox went outside with his papa, because Knox was loving seeing Gimme and Mom and Dad on the video, so we've spared you from that. But I try to think about what hasn't already been said on that. And I was talking with Tori earlier today, and she kind of held my hand, as good friends do. You'll look at the logo, and that logo, and you forget the most important things. And my sweet son-in-law, Brandon, when Elliot was born, it took a long time to figure out how to put our feet in front of each other, the whole family. And we knew at one point it was time to do a fundraiser, and Brandon, being helpful and creative, decided to create a logo. And for those of you who know, Samantha and Brandon were married under the Osage tree. I'm bad at distance, but right over there at Carton. And so he started with a tree. And then to add Elliot into the mix of their life, Elliot took on the form of a giraffe. I don't remember the significance of that, and if you feel like you need to share it, please do. But who would have ever thought, here we are, I don't even know how many years later, 15, 21, yes, that many years later, that logo would signify her life in perpetuity. Man. So I'm going to let Samantha say a few words, and then I want to recognize a few people that are here. Oh, Brandon, go for it.
Today has been quite the day at work, and heading over here, I told Brandy, I said, I'm probably not going to say anything during this piece, but watching that again, I was like, I should really say something. And when I look at this side of the room, especially, and I look at this side of the room and all of our family, and I'm sure there's a lot of people here that I can't see, what wasn't shown in the video was one of the questions was asked to me, what was your first response when you found out the park was going to be named after Elle? And it was, first I was taken back, and second I was humbled, because it was just another time where this community, this great community, is wrapping their arms around our family. And they're doing it in a way that's going to keep Elliot's memory alive for such a long time. And to be able to take our boys to this park and to be able to share her story and her experiences with so many others it's really, really special. So I appreciate that all of you guys are here today, and let's raise some money.
Go for it. This is your chance.
Oh, okay. I love public speaking, especially holding a child in my hands. And I'm really nervous he's going to throw up on me, so we'll just roll with it. I am very humbled to have a park named after my daughter, but I think it's always just kind of been this idea, and we've seen it on paper and seen the plans, and then coming here today, which is definitely a place for our family that we've done a lot with Elle, and I mean, we've had parties here and all sorts of stuff, to have this kind of be the kickoff, it's really great for us. But then walking in and seeing these posters that have been colored by kids, and I mean, the first person I saw was Gina, one of Elliot's therapists, and so it's just kind of taken me back, and I am so grateful that this is not just something of our past, but it's also going to be something of our future. And so I really appreciate everyone who's been a part of this, and everyone who's here today, and everyone who helps kind of make this a reality. So I really appreciate it, and thank you so much.
I do want to point out, these giraffes were from Elliot's room, so we brought a little bit of history with us. Elliot's other grandparents, my husband's outside with Knox, her brother. Terry is right here, and then Cher, the Castros. And then I'm not going to name each person, but my children, too, of which cannot be here, and Maddie, of course. Elliot has a lot of cousins that she never met. So it's another really cool thing that as these children grow up and they go to this park, Elliot becomes more than just a picture on a wall. She becomes a different kind of memory. You know, you never really know the fruits of your path. And for me, Elliot, and kind of pushed me and Maddie and Emma for a minute and Mendel into serving children with special needs. I mean, I'm a magazine publisher turned director of development, which is why I can't raise money for this project. But High Hopes has played a pivotal role in our life. And I invited some of Elliot's friends here today. I don't know if Max is here. Max, that's Ellie G's boyfriend. And then we have Asher and Maddox Dobson. I don't know if they made it inside. And then another sweet friend of ours, Sophie, who it was really sweet when Elliot passed away. We had her equipment, and what do you do with this equipment? And we were able to give it to a very deserving little girl, and they're not here today. But also Eric and Gina, and we have friends from Waves, and we have friends from all the other myriad of service people that take care of our children with special needs. So we are such a blessed community, and this is a huge blessing for our family, and I just appreciate it so much. So thank you all. One more thing.
when you look at this and you can't hear me. It says LG right there. So, anyway, thank you all so much. Oh, yes. See, I'm off my game. Another important family at High Hopes that I got to meet were the Zeidmans, and just randomly ran into Rachel in the lobby, and she shared something with me, and I thought, you know what? This is something that needs to be shared here today. So if Ben wants to come up, and the boys, Baylor, Rachel, come on.
Awesome, thanks. Well, this is a really cool event. Thank y'all for everything you're doing here. This is my son Baylor, my other son Ramsey, and my wife Rachel. And as Brandy mentioned, they both went to High Hopes and graduated from High Hopes and are now at Creekside Elementary. We live here in Franklin, have been here since 2010. My wife and I moved from Nashville in 2010, and that's where we raised our family. So, that said, this summer we found out about the Miracle Park up in Gallatin, which was really cool, and it's an inclusive playground for special needs children. And so we got in the van and we drove up there this summer and got to check it out. And while we were driving up there, I was like, wow, it'd be really cool if we had something like this here in Franklin, in Williamson County. Not even knowing that this was in the works. So we went up there and played in Gallatin at the Miracle Park, and we're driving back, and I think at some point between then and now, we found out that this LEG's Dream World, which is just so cool, is going to be developed here in Franklin. And so we'll be able to have our special needs child and our typical child be able to play together on the same playground, which has never been able to happen before. And we'll be able to invite Baylor's friends to come play on the playground with him so he can be included, because we have not had anything like that. So it's really cool. The even cooler part is we live in Ladd Park, so it's really close to this. So we can almost even walk and ride down there, right, Baylor? So we're extremely excited about this. And you know, coincidentally, Cher and Terry are our neighbors, so we've got kind of a unique connection here. And I remember hearing about LEG and just what a wonderful legacy and tribute to her that she'll be able to bring so much joy to children for generations to come. So this is really cool. So to have a place like this where children can feel included is just very special to us. And very thankful for everybody in this room and the people that brought this together.
Hello, I'm Hamilton Bowman, and this is Tom Curlworth of Friends of Franklin Parks Board, and we're very excited to be here today for a couple reasons. Number one, like Lisa mentioned earlier, this has been 2 years in the making. A lot of planning has gone into this from the committee, and we've got a lot of community members involved on this, and so we're glad to be here today to do the official launch. Also, this is a way for everyone in the community to be involved with this awesome project. If you look up here on the screen, you know, there's various sponsors levels here. You know, we have everything from the Tree of Life, you know, down to the tortoise level. You know, so anyone can be involved with this, and that is the key. Everyone from corporate sponsorships, foundations, large donors, you know, down to everyone in the community can be involved with it, and that's what makes this, you know, so special. If you look at the next slide, you know, it kind of shows, you know, a little bit more about, you know, the community involvement. You know, we've had, you know, a lot of folks involved with this at the committee level. You can see, you know, not just the City of Franklin, Friends of Franklin Parks, but, you know, several other nonprofits have gotten behind this already. Franklin Tomorrow, Leadership Franklin, and various others. And so we expect this is just the beginning and are excited about getting more people involved with this project over time. And there's going to be a lot of ways for us to advertise this. You know, there's a lot of ways to get involved with it. You can see even on these handouts today, we have these codes here where you can scan this. It gives you a way to donate easily. And we're going to continue to get more folks involved over time. And the good news is, you know, with this early involvement, we already have some great progress, you know, towards that $1.5 million goal. And so now I'm going to let Tom kind of go through some of the early progress, because Tom's been involved not just on the committee, but also, you know, donating personally and with his company. So Tom, I'll let you kind of go through some of the early successes here.
Thank you, Hamilton. So as Hamilton said, this is from top to bottom, corporate all the way down to kids. We're going to have kids have boxes that they can contribute pennies or dollars or nickels, whatever. Corporate sponsorships go down to $1,000 or up to $500,000, but we'll take donations or anything from any level. We want families and kids and everybody to be involved. This is a community project. It's a public-private sponsorship. City's offered to put $1.5 million in. We're going to try to raise, we're going to raise $1.5 million. To that end, we've already, as of today, have $170,000 raised. Part of that commitment is Friends of Franklin Parks has take on the responsibility. We will raise in Friends of Franklin Park $100,000. Simmons Bank, I'd like to note them. They were one of the first to step up. Tori, you've got a check there behind you. Paul Craig, president of Simmons Bank, is here. Paul, thank you so much for the donation of $5,000. I'm going to let some of these be your responsibility. I do want to make a mention of Emily and Hamilton. They have committed to raise, to match $25,000. The Bowmans have... This is a tremendous gift on their part, and so it's really kind of out there for the board members of Friends of Franklin Park to contribute. So that's going to be a match dollar for dollar up to $25,000. Again, Friend of Franklin Park, Franklin Tomorrow, Mindy Tate, would you like to say something?
Thanks so much, Tom. I want to note that this slide says first inclusive playground, okay? We're going to continue to dream for the children and families here in Franklin. But Franklin Tomorrow has made an initial commitment of $10,000 to this playground project. So thank you to our board.
Thank you, Mindy. We really appreciate that. Pam Lewis, are you here? Where are you, Pam? She's made a donation of $10,000. Judy Hayes, are you here, Judy? No. Another $10,000. Our architect engineer Barge has made an offer, a donation of $2,500. So thank you all so much. What a great way to kick off an event and have $170,000 already accounted for. I do want to make mention, you see all these? These are all done by kids at High Hopes, at the Boys and Girls Club, New Hope, BGA, and the Franklin Special School District. They're all over, but this is all done by the kids as part of this project. So thank you, kids. We appreciate it.
My name is Tori Barnhill, and I'm with Friends of Franklin Parks, and I just wanted to kind of close this down. It's just been such an amazing celebration to look around. It's kind of all of us hard to keep it together. It's such an emotional and special day. They touched a little bit about the sponsorship, but I want to remind everybody, this is a community project, a community fundraiser. Everybody is a friend of this park. There's so many ways to get engaged and involved. Amy Baggett, raise your hand. We volunteered her. She did a great thing, and the change the way we play is going to be little boxes and Boys and Girls Club and High Hopes. Different groups with children said, hey, we want to be part of this park as well. They're going to have these little cute boxes and start raising money, collecting change. Every penny, every dime is so important. It's equally important. Of course, we love sponsorship dollars. It's going to take that to get across that $1.5 million line. We have sponsorship packets. We'd love to come meet with your groups. Everyone on this committee is working on this. We'd love to speak to the Rotary groups, the Leadership Franklin groups. Everybody's issuing challenges to each other because we know we're going to get it done together. You're going to see these all summer long throughout the park's events. They'll have Change the Way We Play. You'll just see this all over town. So for the next year and a half, 2 years, you know, join us, please, and help us raise this money. And we're all going to play at this playground and be at a ribbon cutting in the very near future. So thank y'all. There are special cookies and petit fours and treats in the other room. And feel free to email us or call us with any questions. Did you have one more?
I was just going to say that every single penny goes towards the contribution to the park. There's That's no right. overhead. There's no expense. It's every single penny is going donated directly to the park. Special needs.
So thank you all for your time today.